What's up, guys? It's your boy, the Battlestar, and in today's video, we're heading back to Skull and Bones. Show you guys another dynamic and another, not game mode, but another thing you can do in Skull and Bones. So right now, we're in the Helm. This is my smuggler's hideout. And we're going to head over to this map. So once you get into that later game, you can work for the Helm to secure different manufactories that are going to be producing different things. Like this one produces opium. This one does rum. This one is also rum. I think this one, one of these is gin. Oh, White Skull gin. White Skull rum, gin, Blue Lotus opium, rum, Skull rum. I purposely picked all the ones that have rum. Now, this area of the map is green because I own all of the manufactories in this area. Had I grabbed this one instead of a level 2, which gives me more, then I would have owned this whole area. Right now, I have 8 out of 8 manufactories. So, we are going to be checking. We're going to be managing them. Most of them are going to need some financial support here soon. So, also, because I own everything in this area, we do have like little bonuses here and there. So we come over to our supply network. We are going to pick up for 1200. We can get 96 sugar canes. We're gonna grab that. While we're there, since that's one spot, we're going to grab everything over there because we need these for opium. So as long as Circle doesn't move, looks like they got a lot of opium over there. Some sugar. All right. Probably should have started with that one seeing as it's closer, but we get more bang for our buck by going the long route. So we're going to go ahead and track that. Head back out to St. Anne, back out to the ship. So like I said, this is the Helm. We are trying to gather pieces of 8 so we can run over here to Yanita, and she runs the Helm on this side of the map. Business progressing? So we can open the black market. They only deal in pieces of 8. So now that we have 3,000, we can actually afford some upgrades. But what I've been looking for, so you can get a bunch of different stuff, different cosmetics. But when you scroll to the bottom, these are different blueprints for different weapons. Right? And so the other thing I was looking for, so here we have different armor blueprints for your ship. What can I try today? These are armors, so you don't get the blueprint, but you get the armor itself. So the one I was looking for is La Fortress 3, I think is what I'm looking for. Actually, no, this is 1250 on the armor. All of this is less. That's 12. This is 1250. So this one gives me a little bit more armor and then different, like it's 6% against explosives, 40% for flooding, 15% for piercing. But I want that armor rating. So real quick, what we're gonna do before we head out. So we're gonna check the ship. No repairs needed. We're gonna go ahead and manage cargo. We're gonna take off stuff that we don't need. Like I don't need ballista bolts because I don't have a ballista just yet. Don't need any of these supplies. Don't need any of this. Most of this is just going to get sent, or all of this really is going to get sent back to the warehouse just because I don't need it on me. So we're going to transfer that to the warehouse. We're going to keep the opium on it, or the juniper berries, because that's how they make the opium, is through those. We're going to check to see, make sure we don't have any sugarcane or any more berries over here. Although that cannon powder was more berries. See, this is the rum. Or this is a rum, really. This is the gin and the rum that I make. So I can actually grab these and we'll sell them to some other people. We'll do that in a little bit. So I do have LaFortress 2, so I'm looking for either LaFortress 3 or something a little higher. So yeah, here we go. We have, oh, so these are the, so that's for opium. So these can go, oh no, they make gin. So we'll keep them. We will also transfer those, these, and this to cargo. So we have the supplies needed. All right, so that's that. We're also gonna manage the ship. Sorry, not cargo, manage ship. Looks like we unlock some new ship cosmetics. And the Rampa cosmetics, that's through the storyline. We do have a few of them almost unlocked completely, so. What armor do we have? On this ship, we have Iron Husk 5. So we do have LaFortress 2, but it's a lower rating. All right. So Iron Husk 5, we got 5 out of 5 weapons. So in the front, we have our Fire Bombardment 2s, but we just picked up Fire Bombardment 3s. So that's going to put us near level 9. And then on the side, we have our Cannon 4s. On the other side, Cannon 4. On the back side, we have Fire Long Gun 2s. And of course, our Mortar. Mortar 1. Technically, the termite rockets are... The rockets will get us to... Would get us to level 9. But I like the way the mortar works so much more. So I'm going to keep the mortar. But I will upgrade that. All right, so we're going to head and talk to, oh, we went up in the leaderboards. Nice. Talk to Yanita, open up that black market and head on down to the very bottom where we have our Gamba Kobe's, LaFortress 3's, the Bastion. This is 1250, so I'm going to go with this one. Yes, we would like to purchase one, please.
Thanks for patronizing my majlis.
These are different furniture blueprints, and of course, these are different weapon blueprints. Termite 3s. I wonder if I have, if she's got any mortars in here. Fire Bombardment 3s I just put on my ship. When you buy the blueprint, it'll let you make it over and over as opposed to buying just a weapon. So we bought that armor. We didn't buy the blueprint. So we don't have to go to... We don't have to build it because we already have it. So we manage our ship. Come down to armor. So we have the Iron Husk. We see that this is a lot better. So bam, now we're well into level 9. I'm pretty sure if we put rockets on here, we'll probably make it to level 10. Nah, not a much of an upgrade. That's fine. So we are going to set sail. So we're heading over to another member of the Helm, who has the supplies that we need so we can turn around and give it to our manufacturers to boost their productivity. In that route, our people are probably going to run out of funding, so we'll probably have to fund them mid-run, but...
We will get the goods rapidly and be back
safe at there. You're the lady. Kick it. So we're heading all the way out here. No, we're leaving the safe zone. But this area is pretty calm, so I don't have to worry about it. Most of these guys are like level 1 and 2s. Huh? I don't know why the ship tilts like that when you're on turbo mode. So like I said, we're going to sail straight out, straight to them, grab all of the supply, sail back down here and start funding our manufactories. So let's say we got some stuff going on down here, but we'll stay focused. Bro, I feel like there's always a storm over there. I feel like there's never any clear skies or nothing over there. Look, he's tilted too. That's another player. And who is this? That's probably another player too. Because I haven't seen anybody with that that marking. Eat some fish to boost my stamina. Or to regain my stamina. This is the lower, this is like the beginning area, so there's not really much going on here. Once you spread out and level up a little bit more, you get a little more stuff going on. Like I said, see, level 2 for our clan, but you got level 8s out there. Which we just were level 8, we made it to level 9. We're halfway between level 9 and level 10. So I think the person that we're looking to meet is actually another ship. So we won't be getting off or docking at any of the islands. It's kind of just trading some silver for some supplies and then heading back. I'm pretty sure these are the starry maps. Yeah. Star charts. Part of a side quest for the sea people. So you can sail all the way out there. Looks like we got company. Both level 10s. All three of them are level 10s. It's possible they got nothing to do with me, so. Let's slow down just so we can get a nice beat on them if we need to. So we're still 2,400 meters away from our destination. That ship's a problem. Privateers. Privateers are always going to start a fight with you, especially once you've joined the Helm. Privateers, skirmishers, rogues. Can I hit out that far? No, but almost. So, La Compagnie is there. That's the ship we're trading with. That's the DMC. Why is the DMC out here? They're on us. The DMC chose the wrong water to be in because they do not like him. There's another privateer over there. I haven't done anything yet, so hopefully they're not going to mess with me. This is the ship I'm looking for. Now, I could sink them, but because, you know, there's no loyalty among thieves. What is going on up here? I just say, that's DMC. Oh, that's the Twins Chorus fleet. Bro, all I'm trying to do is get some supplies. See, for all of you that were watching the beginning part of this video and you're like, that game looks pretty empty. Just gotta go to the right spots. Bro, DMC's taking a beating, but he's leading them right. That's a whale. Nice. He's leading them right to us. Dealer's occupied with what? Who's he fighting? I'm trying not to crash into him. I think he's running. So I think we should... I agree, bro. Let's go. Let's get out of here. They're on me. I can't have him sink my ship because I need that supplies. Probably should have shot the bigger ship with the mortar. Dealer, get out of there. Torpedo's missing. He's got a healer? Really? Torpedoes. All right, where's my dealer? He's dealing with them. Fire muskets. Reload the cannons. Is he still fighting? No, he's worried about me sinking his boy. And that's fine. I'd rather all attention on me. Cut the sail one. Hit him. That's that new fire bombardment threes. We're trying to hit that crew boarding. The privateer in the back. Hey, as long as you get one rope, you got him. So we're trying to rob these cats and get them out of here before the other ships show up. Yeah. DMC is down. He's down. You're gonna loot his stuff. Look, I don't want no beef with the company right now. Brace for torpedoes. Loop. Brace. We gotta get out of here. Hit him with the muskets. All right, when the timer cools off, we're gonna hit him with we're gonna heal with repair kits too. I don't even know where the he's over there. I was like, I don't even know where the guy who's supposed to be giving me stuff is at. I don't think he helped me with the fight at all. I'm 100% positive that he just left me to fight this on my own. Like, I haven't caught any wind. Who are you healing? Psych. Torpedoes. This is why I put the sniper cannons in the back. That dude's like, yo, he bringing trouble my way. I'm out. All I wanted was some supplies. I should have known that this wasn't going to go my way. 3, 2, 1. This is going to be too close. Fire muskets. We've almost got them. Torpedoes. It's a trade-off of firing cannons and bracing for impact. That's everything. The problem is the guy that we're looking for is way out there, and all we're doing is starting problems. I got 7 seconds before I can use the healing, before I can use a repair kit. The torpedo's coming. Just trying to get some stuff. Alright, so my hope is that I can hit this dude, grab the supplies, and split before we get into any trouble. I think we're far enough away. But we can do this real quick. The torpedo should fade. Really? The torpedo's gonna come all the way over here? There it is. Beeler is occupied. Yeah, I can tell why the dealer's occupied. I wish the dealer would open fire. That's what I want him to do. Trying to hit that weak spot in the back there. Why does it sound like more ships in front of me? Are they sunk the dealer? So what does that mean for me? Well, hopefully I can go over there and grab what I need. Hey, in all fairness, they sunk the dealer. I didn't have nothing to do with that. Is that a new dealership? Because that really was, oh, whew, I got a little bit nervous. Down. Who are you sinking? New people showed up. That means he's not gonna do what I need him to do. Oh wait, interact. Yeah, give me everything. Give me everything. Go, 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 go. Why? He's still talking. Turn away from the torpedoes. I can't see because of the banner. Oh my god, they're going to keep giving me banners. I'm trying to throw a mortar. All right. Now that chaos is under some kind of whatever. Alright, so it looks like they're out of funding, so we're going to fund them for the next 4 hours. And then we're going to head to them to drop supplies off. Maybe. If we can make it. You missed! Of course, I'm like sailing right into the wind. So I can't get anywhere, or any type of speed. See if I can, nope. I'm gonna end up. Well, out of four, I only took three of them. Stamina was getting pretty low there. We're trying to make a run for it. I'm starting to wonder if maybe I should swap out the. If I should swap out the mortar for torpedoes, because these cats are making it look easy. New Empire opportunities are available, but I have 8 out of 8, so I can't get any more. Just trying to make it out of here in one piece. And like, these torpedoes got some range to them. Like, the reason I picked the mortar is because like, I can hit from out here. Pretty sure it's gonna miss. He's turning. He's trying to turn away from it. That's a hit. Barely did any damage, but it's a hit. I think they're within range. Copy, you reloading. Race. I'm gonna have to cut the trying to pull away. Then we managed to do it. Hit that single repair kit to patch it up. All right, we managed to get away. So we're going to resupply all of our manufactories with resources so that they can get a boost in production. We're going to listen to some sea shanties while that happens. Like I said, we're setting here. As you can see, the funding has run out on so many of these. So we're going to hit them up. There's some money to make more rum. More money to make rum. Who else is tracking me? Nobody out here. Ooh. That guy? That's who's after me? He's about to hit this dude. He's Kampani. That's not Farah clan. That's the Ungana. Yeah, he wants beef with me. And somehow the Kampani wants in on it. Alright, slow down then. I need that stamina for bracing. Get the sniper cannons ready. Trying to hit that one spot there. This is why I put the sniper cannons in the back, is even though that I'm running, I can still fight. Oof. Alright, we're still heading the right way. And brace! Somehow we're always sailing into the wind over here. We're ready to sink that. How about that? Brace. If you brace, it helps to not take so much health off of you. But the brace is also somewhat on a cooldown. We're almost there. See, this is what I'm saying. These torpedoes are like ridiculous. I think he's running. And without even trying, we have more enemies. I'm gonna hug the coast. I think those torpedoes are gonna miss. Man just ran through his own ship. Zero loyalty. Wait, can I loot that stuff? No, almost. Bro, why you shooting rounds at me? It was your guy that did it. There's no way around it. He'll turn out, but or he'll speed through. Alright, so we made it to our manufactory that will be making rum. Unfortunately, we're under fire. So I don't know if it's gonna let us interact or not. It will. I'm gonna get rid of this guy first. Oh, so you can only brace or... How did that not hit? Fire muskets! Get the bombardments lined up. I don't know why he decided to turn right then, but he's trying to ram me. Ha, we landed though. Ah, his backup is here. We're not gonna collect the profits. We're gonna start a speeding run. I still got 20 seconds on. I'm gonna try to see if I can. Oh, I'm losing them in the river. Because, like I said, they won't come out here. So, yeah, if you can get to your supplies, you can get them to your manufactories. It will boost their productivity, which will increase the profit speed or the speed of earning profits. I'm trying to avoid these torpedoes without crashing into the side of this. See, they won't come in here. Like I said, this is Skull and Bones. I am your host, the Battlestar. We ran out. We picked up some supplies, and we are supplying our manufactories while also providing funding so they can make us some gin, some rum, and some opiums. So if you enjoyed this video, definitely smash the like button, subscribe to the channel, check out some of the other stuff that we got going on in Skull and Bones. As always, I'm your host, the Battlestar. Peace out.